Hello students, today we are going to discuss about last academic chapter from Thetis taxonomic aids. So today we are going to discuss about taxonomic aids, that means how we can use taxonomy as a tools. Okay, in which area we can apply taxonomy as a tools. So this is the taxonomic aids. So look at this, here you can see first you can use taxonomy in this place, this is the herbarium. Okay, so we will discuss in detail each, here you can see here each tools we will discuss in detail. So first one is a herbarium, second one is a botanical gardens. You may visited this botanical garden sometime. Okay, and third one is a zoological parks, you know it as a zoos. Okay, and fourth one is a museum, you may heard all this about. Okay, and fifth one is a key, then flora, then manuals, monograph and catalogs. So in this lecture, in today's lecture, we will discuss each and every tools here which is written, okay, which is used as a taxonomical tools or aids. First of all, let me discuss about herbarium. So first one is a herbarium. So what is a herbarium? Here it is a storehouse, one type of a storehouse it is, or repository we can say, of a plant species that are dried and pressed. You must be remember here the plant species which is stored or reposited is a dried form or in a dyed form. Okay, dried and dyed form. Okay, dried, it is pressed and preserved on a sheet. So here you can see the sheet. Okay, paper sheet is there, that is called herbarium paper sheet. Okay, on which you can see plant part which is dried already and pressed. Okay, it is preserved on these sheets and are arranged according to universally accepted classification, which we have already discussed in previous lectures. So universally accepted classification, according to the classification system, it is arranged in these cupboards. Okay, herbarium sheets are labeled with information. Here you can see this is the herbarium sheet and it is labeled one. Here you can this in this corner you can observe. Okay, so it is this is the herbarium sheets and it is labeled with the information. So you must be remember which type of information must be there on the herbarium sheet. This may be asked in board exam. Okay, so here herbarium sheet is there and it is labeled, and which type of information will be labeled on the herbarium sheet? So you have to write down about the date and place of collection, when you have collected the specimen and what is the place or where is the, from where it is collected. Okay, then English and local botanical names, you must write down English name, botanical name. Okay, that is a scientific name, botanical name itself is a scientific name. Okay, then local name also you should mention. Then family, okay, and who have collected the sample. Okay, so collector's name, means all this information must be there on the herbarium sheet. Okay, next here you can see botanical gardens. You have several time you may have visited. In Surat we have also one botanical garden is there. Okay, so there are a specialized garden. It is different from the normal garden. Okay, here all plants which is grown here is labeled with the scientific name, local name and all that. Okay, so this is a different from the normal gardens. So botanical gardens, how it is different from the normal garden? Because in the normal garden there is no labeling on the plants. Okay, but here in the botanical garden there is a specific information on the plant is written. There are specialized garden having collection of a living plants. Here all collection of a living plant will be there, but in case of a herbarium it was a dried and dyed living dyed plants, right? So here is a living plant and in the herbarium there is a dyed plant, so you must be remember. Okay, so here also collection of plants is there, but here a living form of plant will be there. So living plants for the reference and identification here, and it is collected here. Each plant is labeled. This is the very unique thing. Okay, how it is differentiated from the normal garden? Because here each plant which is grown here is labeled with the botanical name and family. So anyone whoever visit the garden come to know what is the scientific name of this particular plant, or what is what is the botanical name, what is the family of a particular plant, like that. Okay, so here some list is given. You should remember this all garden name. Okay, so famous botanical garden here it is given, a national international botanical garden is this one. So Royal Botanical Garden is a very well known all over the world. Okay, so this is the in the queue, at the queue it is, and in the England. Okay, so you must be remember all these famous botanical garden. Next one is the Indian Botanical Garden, and that is in the West Bengal, India. Okay, or Howrah, there is a place that is in the West Bengal state. Next is a National Botanical Research Institute that is present in the Lucknow, India. So you must be remember famous botanical garden name. It may be several times it may be asked in the exams, already asked in the exams. Next here you can see Biological Museum. Okay, so museum, in the museum you can see all the animals. This is for the animals. Herbarium is for the plants. Botanical garden is also for the plants. Okay, so now here is the specimen related to animals. Okay, so mostly animal it is here, but sometime it preserve plants also. Okay, so sometime if it is having a plant, then it is called herbarium. Okay, and if it is like this, then it is called herbarium. Okay, and here you can see animal preserved in such a form. Okay, and that is called biological museum. So it is a collection of a preserved plant. Okay, and animals. Sometime what happen in biological museum, there is also plants and animal both. Okay, sometime it is a collection of a preserved plants and the animal. Mostly it is related to animals for study and the references. So this is about the biological museum, and maybe you have visited so many type of museums. Then what a museum will have? A museum will contain a specimen preserved in the preservatives. Okay, several chemicals will be used, that is in the form of solution in a container or jars. Okay, and dried specimen of a plant and animals. Okay, insect preserved in the insect. Well, this is the very special kind of boxes are there in which insects will be preserved after collection and killing and pinning. Okay, this all is the stages for the insect boxes. Stuff larger animal here, you cannot put this type of animal in the jar. Okay, so you must be stuff this type of animals. So larger animal will be stuffed out. Okay, like birds and mammals. Here this all are stuffing is done. Okay, in this stuffing is done. What is the stuffing? Stuffing is a special kind of chemical which is filled inside the cavity of this animal. Okay, so whole internal structures, internal organs will be removed, and then it is filled with some chemicals along with some grasses and all that, and by this way it is stuffed. Okay, and it will remain so many years for longer period of time. And such a stuffed larger animal like birds and mammal will be present in the museum. And then collection of animal skeleton is also there in the this type of biological museum. Sometimes only a gallery is there which is having only animal skeletons. Okay, so this is all about the biological museum. Next is the zoological parks, and in short it is called zoos. And you may be visited the Surat Zoological Park. Okay, and that is very famous. These are the places where live wild animal, here live wild animal will be kept. Okay, in protected environment under human care. Okay, so here live wild animal will be kept. Okay, under the protection, protected environment under human care. It help to learn about their food habits. Okay, and behavior. So in this zoos you can observe habits and behavior of such a different kind of, you can see here such galleries are there. Okay, so here you can see deers, and there's alligators and birds and all that, elephants. Okay, tortoise, all this different kind of wild animal will be kept over there under several conditions, under protected environments. Next next is a tool which is a key. Okay, next tool is a key. So what is the key? Let me discuss. It is an analytical method of identification of an organism. You know very well this classification is a very lengthy process and very confusing process, right? So here what happened, key is utilized as a tool of a taxonomy. It is an identical or analytical method of identification of organism. So based on similarities and dissimilarities, here these two lines, two words you must be remember. Okay, this identification method by using key will be done with the help of similarities and dissimilarities. Just you have to compare this both, whether this animal is similar to this one or not, whether this is dissimilar to this one or not, like that. Okay, and you can see here key is a branching type of key, here it is given. Okay, so dry skin, whether it is present, if yes, then kept it here. Okay, if it is no, then keep it here, like that. Hair is present or not? If yes, then it will be divided in this group, and if no, then divided into this group. Further, one question, opposable thumbs, yes, if it is present, then here it will be classified, like this. So this is the way by using which you can identify and classify the organism, and that is called key. It is based on contrasting characters, generally in a pair called couplet. And this contrasting character is called couplet. Okay, here you can see yes or no. Generally, it is yes or no answers. So, couplet is there. Okay, so contrasting character generally in a pair, and that is called couplet. Each couplet has a two opposite option. Here you can see no and yes, both are opposite option. Of these, only relevant option is accepted and other will be rejected. And by this way, you can identify the organism based on similarity and dissimilarity. Each statement in the key is called lead. You must be remember these all. Okay, so many terminologies here also. A key, it may be asked, okay, what is a key? Then couplet. Okay, then you must be remember this lead. What is a lead? Each statement which is used during the key analysis, okay, that is called lead. You must be remember this. And this is the key which is of branching type. This you can see here, branches are formed, and that's why it is called branching type of key. Next, here you can see another type of key, and that is a bracketed type. Okay, so this one is a branching type of key, and this one is the bracketed type. So here question will be asked, and accordingly this you can see answer will be given, and accordingly finally you can come to the conclusion that this organism must be classified into this group. So this is the bracketed type. Okay, these all are the sentences, and you have to just answer it out up to the final answer and then conclusion. And here key branching is there, questions, opposite questions, then answer, and leads. Okay, you can see some questions are there, it will be called as a leads, and then finally it will be concluded like this. So key is very unique tool, we can say, which is used during the taxonomy or classification of the animals or plant both. Next is a flora. So here it is the actual account of habitat, different kind of habitat, you know very well, on the earth is there. Okay, starting from aquatic to the this terrestrial. Okay, so this actual account of habitat, different kind of aquatic to terrestrial, all different kind of habitat here accounted. And distribution of plant species of a given area will be considered. So flora is just used for the plant species. Okay, so distribution of a plant species all over the world in different habitat, okay, it will be considered, and that is called flora. Okay, and next is the manuals. So what is the manuals? Manuals are the record that contain information for identification of a name of a species, okay, found in an area. So this is also very important. Manuals are the record. It is one kind of a record that contain information, very important information for identification of a name of a species found in that particular area. So several characteristics will be given on that, and based on that, that information identification will be done. Okay, next here you can see, next is a monograph. Okay, so what is a monograph? These are the records that contain information of any one taxon. You must be remember. Okay, so what is a monograph? Monograph is a record that contain information on any one taxon. Okay, next is a catalog, and it is an alphabetical list, like just like a dictionary. Okay, catalog is a one type of dictionary, we can say biological dictionary, in which in alphabetical order or a list species will be given A to Z. Like that. So it is the catalog. So it is an alphabetical list of a species, and by this you can get the idea which one is the species, or identification will be done. Okay, so it is an alphabetical list of a species, just like a dictionary. So here you can see today's homework. Okay, you should write down this homework and just solve all MCQs from the exercise 1. And before we finish this lecture, let me summarize all topic by using one animation video. So look at this video.
Our planet is filled with numerous living organisms. To simplify the study of these organisms, they are classified into convenient categories based on their characteristics. This classification process is known as taxonomy. Taxonomic studies require careful identification of the organisms, for which intensive laboratory and field studies are carried out, and actual specimens of plant and animal species are collected. These studies help in disciplines such as agriculture, forestry, industry, and in knowing the biodiversity. Over the years, biologists have developed many methods and techniques that help in taxonomic studies. These are also known as taxonomical aids. Herbariums, botanical gardens, museums, zoological parks, and keys are some examples of taxonomical aids. Let's learn a little more about these aids. A herbarium is a storehouse where a collection of dried plant specimens are mounted on sheets, labeled, and systematically arranged based on the universally accepted system of classification for use in scientific study. Details like the date and place of collection, the English, local and botanical names, the family of the specimens, and the collector's name are also recorded. These herbarium specimens are often used as reference material in taxonomic studies. Another place that provides taxonomical aid is a botanical garden. A wide variety of plants are cultivated in these gardens for scientific research, conservation, display, and education. Each plant is labeled with its botanical or scientific name and family. Some of the famous botanical gardens are at Kew in England, the Indian Botanical Garden in Howrah, and the National Botanical Research Institute in Lucknow. Biological museums, set up in educational institutions, also act as taxonomical aids. These museums have collections of preserved plants and animals, which are used for study and reference. They are preserved in jars using preservative solutions or as dry specimens. Insects are collected, killed, pinned, and then preserved in insect boxes. Larger animals are typically stuffed and preserved, or their skeletons are displayed. Zoological parks or zoos also help in taxonomical studies. These places house wild animals in protected environments similar to their natural habitats under human supervision. An animal's food habits and behavior can be studied here. A biological key is another taxonomical aid used for the identification of plants and animals. It is a list of questions that help identify and classify a living organism. Each question presents contrasting characters of an organism in a pair called a couplet. To classify the organism, the character similar to the organism has to be chosen. So in a couplet, one character is accepted and the other is rejected. Answering the questions in this analytical manner helps in identifying the organism. Separate taxonomic keys are required for each taxonomic category, such as family, genus, and species, for the purposes of identification. Other taxonomical aids like flora, manuals, and monographs are also used. A flora is a document that contains information about the plants of a particular country, region, or time. Manuals provide information that helps in the identification of the names of plant and animal species found in a specific area. A monograph is a written account or description of a single taxon. It provides detailed information about a particular species and how it fits in with the overall taxonomy and classification. In today's scenario, when many plant and animal species are endangered, Taxonomical aids play a crucial role in studying the important facets of living organisms and saving important information about them for future reference.
In next lecture, we will start new unit, and that is unit number 2, in which we will start chapter number 5, that is the morphology of a flowering plant, in which we will start learning about the topic roots. So till that, goodbye.